Hi all, a very good morning. Welcome to the session. This is VC from VC's Academy. Today's class we will discuss about genes. What are genes? What is phenotype? And what is genotype in detail? Let's go to the lesson without any lead. What are genes? Genes are the basic structure of life. With genes only, the structure of life has started. Foundation of biology is genetics. At the simplest level, if you want to explain it at very easy level, genetics is a matter of genotype. What is genotype? The genes which you have, and phenotype, the traits those genes give you. It means physical appearance and the internal factors both together gives an organism its shape, structure. And genotype and phenotype define a large part of what an organism is. In order to define an organism, we can define with genotype and phenotype. Genotype and phenotype are considered as two fundamental terms in the science of genetics. If you take genetics and if you observe what genotype and phenotype are, these are the two fundamental things or terms which are used to explain or define an organism in the science of genetics. Two terms are often used at the same time to describe the same organism. In order to explain organism, we use both the terms like genotype and phenotype. These two terms are different, but these two are used to explain or describe the same organism in two ways. But there is a difference in the between genotype and phenotype. If you observe, there are many variations in genotype and phenotype. An organism's genotype is the set of genes in its DNA responsible for a particular trait. If you observe the genotype of an organism, it is set of genes, a group of genes in its DNA, which is responsible for a particular trait. Take it as height, weight, color, texture, skin tone. Everything is a trait. So all these are expressed by a particular set of genes in an organism. If you see here, the genotype gives the information about DNA, whereas phenotype gives the physical expression of those genes. Take an example. We will take an example, that is mice. We will take two that which look virtually identical. If you see, they are visually they are identical, but they may have different genotypes. If you observe the image, you can clearly understand what the variations it can be. Coming to genotype, so we will discuss what is genotype. Very first question when we discuss about genotype is how genotype affect phenotype. Answer for this: genotype is a collection of genes responsible for the various genetic traits of a given organism. If you take a particular organism, if we observe the genotype is the collection of genes which are responsible for various genetic traits given for a particular organism which we have selected. It could be plant, it could be animal, it could be man, or it could be bat, or whatever it is. Genotype refers specifically to the genes, not the traits. That is, the raw information in an organism's DNA. The end product, we can call it as phenotype or expressed product. But if you take the raw material or raw information of an organism, that comes under genes, that which refer the genotype. Genotype is determined by the makeup of alleles, which are a pair of genes responsible for particular traits. So how to determine the genotype is by the makeup of alleles. Alleles are nothing but a character's contrasting pair, and these pair of genes are responsible for that particular traits. An allele can be made up of two, one with dominant or recessive, both the dominant or both recessive. The combination of the two and which one is dominant determines what trait the allele will express. Generally, the recessive one will be dormant condition and the dominant character will be exhibited. That shows what the trait is expressing outside as phenotype. Genotype simply means what alleles are carried in a particular organism's DNA. We can simply say that genotype is nothing but the alleles that which are carried by particular organism's DNA. It can be determined by simple observation, can't be determined by simple observation. It requires biological testing. So simply seeing an organism and telling that it is having genotype difference, we cannot say it, but we have to do some biological testing so that we can determine what the genotype it possesses and how it differs from other one. Genotype is inherited from an organism's parent and expresses all of the genetic information about it. So genotype is inherited from an organism's parent. A parent gives the genotype to its offspring and all the genetic information is expressed in the offspring. Coming to the genotype examples. It is hard to provide concrete examples of genotype. The term just means the genes particular organism has. If you say genotype, it gives us the information about the genes that which we are talking about a particular organism. So that particular organism has the set of genes, that is what given as genotype. Any example of a genotype would just be a chart of a particular living thing's chromosomes or DNA molecules responsible for various genetic traits. In order to express the genotype, we must take a chart and prepare it, and we can express the chromosomes and its DNA molecules which are responsible for various genetic traits. However, having certain genes does have observable results. What are they? For example, if you met someone with albinism, you would know that they most likely have a mutated TYR gene, because that's the most common cause of albinism. We come across people who is having albinism, see that they are having the mutated TYR gene. That is what the reason for the cause of albinism. That mutated TYR gene, which is caused by an enzyme tyrosinase, is part of their genotype. Albinism is part of their phenotype. Here we can clearly distinguish the mutated gene, which is called as TYR gene, or which produces tyrosinase enzyme, which causes the albinism, is called genotype, and that which expressed as albinism is part of their phenotype. Suppose you have brown eyes. The visible eye color is your phenotype, but it tells us nothing about your genotype. So when we see different eye colors, we can simply say that they are having different eye color, but that will not give us the information about their genotype. Multiple different genes affect eye color in humans, and in any of them could manifest dominant or recessive traits in your phenotype, that is the unique shade of brown in your eyes. If you see, there are multiple different types of genes which affect the color of eye in humans, and any one of them could manifest or produce dominant or recessive traits in your phenotype that gives the unique shade of brownness in your eyes. Phenotype. What is phenotype? The word phenotype is what you see. It means the visible or observable expression of the result of genes which are combined with the environmental influence on an organism's appearance or behavior. If you see the phenotype, it is the visible expression or which we can observe with our eyes, and it is the result of genes and its combination with the environmental influence on the organism appearance as well as behavior. Everything from the shape of a bird's wing to the song of a humpback whale can be considered part of the phenotype. So coming to this, even the shape of a bird's wing, or take the structure of a plant, gives us the phenotype. All the observable aspects of that animal that are determined at least in part by its gene is called phenotype. Into phenotype examples. Phenotype means concrete results of an organism's genotype. What it states? The concrete results which an organism exhibits by its genotype is nothing but the phenotype. phenotype therefore is observable in nature. Every trait determined by a gene, even partially, is parts of a phenotype. If you take a gene or a trait which is exhibited partially or only 50% is exhibited, that also is part of phenotype. Just a few of countless examples of phenotype of living things is as follows. There are n number of examples, but we quoted only few. What are they? Eye color is a phenotype example. Hair color, we have different types of hair colors. And height, individual shoe size. If you take and observe the foot length or shoe size, it differs from individual to individual. Certain types of diseases, and there are many types of diseases which are unique and which have differences. Size of a bird's beak, if you length of a fox tail, if you observe the fox group and if you observe the tail, each fox tail differ from one another. Color of stripes on a cat, size and shape of the spots on a dog's back. And if you observe the dog's back, some breeds like take Dalmatian, if you observe the spots on its back and shape and size that differ in each dog, that what makes it different from other. I hope you all understood the concept. Thank you.